When I was a kid, there was no series of three words that got me more hyped than Sonic the Hedgehog. When I look back at my childhood, I legit think Sonic was my favorite thing, period. Like, there was no thing in the world I liked more, not even exaggerating. And yes, I played Sonic on my GameCube, PS2, Game Boy Advance, DS, freaking 2006 LG cell phone. But I mean, everyone talks about the Sonic games. What about the other stuff? Baby Fofi was a Sonic super fan, so he played the games, read the comics, bought the toys, and watched the cartoons. There have been a surprising number of Sonic cartoons over the years. Yep, five, to be exact. And they just announced a sixth. So, I like Sonic, I like cartoons, let's talk about them. But before we get started, I gotta give a huge thank you to today's sponsor, Wondershare Filmora. Video editing is something I know a lot about. I've been doing it professionally since 2014, and it's legit how I spend most of my time. But back when I was first starting out, it was kind of a struggle. It's just hard to find good, easy-to-use editing programs without dropping a ton of money. And that's where Wondershare Filmora comes in with Filmora 10. This is their latest editing software that's great for beginners and more experienced editors. It's chock full of built-in effects, transitions, filters, and even royalty-free music and sound effects. Plus, this latest version has new features like keyframing and motion tracking, which I'm stoked about. See this? See how this Sonic is moving around, jumping, and spinning like crazy? That's keyframing. And it's like the most important effect I use for every single one of my videos. So if any of you guys are interested in learning video editing for yourself, Filmora 10 is a great way to get started. It's easy to understand, it's got a lot of options, and best of all, it's free to try. Just head down to the top link in the description to download the free trial version of Filmora 10. Now, it is a trial version, so your videos are gonna have a watermark on them, but you still get everything you need to learn how to edit and make some really cool videos. And it's not like a time trial thing either. You can use this free version as long as you want. But if you do decide to upgrade, Wondershare Filmora has even more options and features available to you, like their new paid add-on Silence Detection that automatically detects and cuts out dead air from your video, which can really cut down on audio editing time. Which, trust me, takes forever. But even if you just stick with the free to try version, Filmora 10 has everything you need to start editing really cool videos. So be sure to click the top link in the description to check it out. Big thanks to Wondershare Filmora for sponsoring, and now let's get back to Sonic. Believe it or not, I think my first ever exposure to the Sonic franchise was through the cartoons. I have a very specific memory of watching the first ever Sonic cartoon way back in the 90s. The show was called The Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog. It premiered in 1993, and it is a mess. It's a wacky, colorful comedy series about Sonic and Tails stopping Robotnik's evil plans through, like, Bugs Bunny antics. Sonic was famously voiced by Jaleel White, aka Steve Urkel, and Robotnik looked like this, unfortunately. It's loud, it's crazy, it's extreme, it's kinda hard to watch, honestly. It gives off generic, nameless cartoon playing in the background of a movie kind of vibes. If you've never heard of it, but it looks familiar, you've probably seen the memes going around from the Sonic Says PSAs. You know, that's no good, that's from this show. But I remember being a little kid watching The Adventures of Sonic on a VHS rented from Blockbuster. There is no sentence more 90s than the one I said just now. And the only episode from that VHS I ever remembered was called Sonic Song. A country singer writes a song about Sonic and it becomes a huge hit. And good lord, that dang terrible song got stuck in my head and hasn't left since the freaking 90s. And since I didn't own any Sonic games at the time, that was my introduction to the franchise, an annoying country version of the Sonic theme. Overall, Adventures of Sonic is fine, I guess. I know I would have dug it back in the day had I not been like -3 when it was new. As an adult though, yeah, the show's kinda dumb. But I gotta give it credit for being my first ever introduction to Sonic, and a bit of a meme. But this wasn't the only Sonic cartoon on the block at the time. Like a week after Adventures of Sonic premiered, we got another show called Sonic the Hedgehog. Though everyone just called it Sonic Sad AM.
For you see, back in the olden times, TV channels aired one new episode of a cartoon every Saturday morning instead of releasing them all at once on a streaming app. Honestly, the new system is way better. I'm not sad about the change at all.
But yeah, Sonic Sad AM. I have a soft spot for this one. I watched it on DVD like a decade after it premiered, and it's pretty cool. It's also about Sonic fighting Robotnik, but they take it a bit more seriously in this one. The city is ruled ruled by robots under Robotnik's control. But Sonic and a group of freedom fighters, aka all of the characters from the Sonic comics, are trying to put things right. And where Adventures of Sonic was a Looney Tunes kind of comedy, Sonic Sad AM is more of an action-adventure show with, like, a real plot and everything. The tone's darker, Robotnik's like an actual villain in this one, but it still has the same DNA as the Adventures cartoon. The character designs are the same, except for Robotnik. Sonic's still voiced by Urkel, but man, side by side, the shows are night and day. I like the show a lot, though it's been a long time since I've seen it. I sold my DVD set years ago, and apparently, they're worth $100 now! And unfortunately, my love for Sonic is not quite vast enough to justify spending $100 on a DVD. $20, however, is a lot more manageable. So instead, I got a copy of Sonic Underground. This was the last of the 90s Sonic cartoons, and I think it's safe to say it's the most infamous? It's definitely the weirdest one. So, Adventures of Sonic was just about Sonic and Tails. Sonic Sad AM was about Sonic, Tails, and a bunch of characters that are now classics from the comics. But Underground is about Sonic and his siblings? So in this show, Sonic, his brother Manic, and his sister Sonia are the children of a queen. Okay, sure. But they're separated after Robotnik overthrows the queen and takes over. Now it's up to Sonic, Manic, and Sonia to fight Robotnik and find their mom. It's all part of some prophecy. They had to be separated so it could be fulfilled. It's a bunch of gobbledygook. So it's another post-apocalyptic action-adventure show with Sonic and friends, but this show attempts to stand out with a couple of unique elements. For one, there's the voice acting. Sonic is still voiced by Jaleel White, but so are his brother and sister. Sonic sounds like he always has, Manic sounds fine, but Sonia, I'm sorry, she just sounds like Urkel. She really does. It's kind of distracting.
Oh my gosh, if Robotnik perfects this, his spies could sneak up on freedom fighters.
Well, through the teeth, over the gums, look out, stomach, here it comes.
But wait, it can get weirder, because these three, they have a band. And that means this show has musical numbers. Aren't you excited?
You must sing the song that is in your heart, young hedgehog.
Hey, whoa, wait. What song? How come nobody ever says what they mean? Song in my heart? What does that mean?
Song in my heart? What does that mean? Why does no one ever say what they mean? What does that mean? What song? What does that mean?
I guess the songs aren't awful, but watching this animated Sonic rock a power ballad with Pink and Green Sonic just feels wrong. I don't like it. Oh, and Knuckles is here now? That's the first, I guess. So yeah, basically Sonic Underground is a weird fanfiction version of Sonic Sad AM, and it makes me uncomfortable. But here's the thing. All three of these 90s Jaleel White era Sonic cartoons were not shows I grew up on. I watched them a little when I was a kid, but for the most part, they were before my time. So let's massively overcorrect and skip ahead to Sonic Boom. This is the most recent Sonic cartoon of the bunch. I'm saving a particular show for the end, and it premiered on Cartoon Network back in 2014. Unlike all the other shows we've talked about, Sonic Boom is 3D instead of 2D and is actually based on a particular Sonic game. It just so happens to be based on some of the worst Sonic games. The Sonic Boom experiment was a pretty weird period in Sonic's already insane history. They were trying to, like, reinvent Sonic with a spin-off series, and they went hard, releasing two games and a TV series all in the same month. And pretty much all of it failed, except the cartoon. It wasn't a huge show, but it definitely caught on a little and ran for 3 years. Fourth verse, same as the first, Sonic Boom is also about Sonic fighting Eggman along with his friends. Tails, Knuckles, Amy Rose, and the inevitable original character all these shows have to have for some reason, Styx the Badger. And they fight off evil using the strongest weapon imaginable. Self-referential, fourth-wall-breaking meta-humor. Yeah, well, all the other Sonic shows are known for their slapstick, story, or ability to unnerve, Sonic Boom is mainly known for its comedic writing. And it kinda reached meme status thanks to all these clips of the show making references to the real-world Sonic franchise, fan fiction, acknowledging the audience, the writers, fan response and criticism, and the more I'm saying this, the more I realize Sonic Boom is just Teen Titans Go, but for Sonic. And I know that might sound like an insult to some people, but if you know me, you know I like Teen Titans Go and I love meta-humor, so Sonic Boom is right up my alley. I'm pretty sure it's the only one of these Sonic cartoons that actually makes me laugh. on purpose. I'd have more to say about it, but I'm actually in the middle of binging it right now. I'm really enjoying it. And I know for a fact I would have been obsessed with this show as a kid. It's everything Baby Fofi loved. But unfortunately, the show came out almost 2 decades after I was born, so like the other shows, there's no way I could have grown up on this. What I did grow up with, though, was Sonic X. Yeah, this was my show back in the day. This was an anime series from around 2003 that was more based on the Sonic Adventure games. Here in the States, it was part of a Saturday morning cartoon block that I really want to make a dedicated video about one day, the Fox Box. It's all about Sonic being transported from his world into ours and being taken in by this kid named Chris, who just happens to be filthy, stinking rich, dude. Seriously, look at his house. Look at his house! Sonic literally blipped out of his reality and landed in the freaking lap of luxury, dude. Sonic X was basically the exact perfect show for a budding young Sonic fanboy like me. It looked exactly like all the games I was playing, had all the characters I'd want to see, and just like everything else Sonic related, was just the right amount of stupid. Like, I remember this show being a little more serious, but when I checked it out on Netflix, I realized that I was a very large amount of wrong. For some reason, Baby Fofi never questioned why there was a full-fledged Formula One racing team working for the local police department. I was just so stoked to see the blue boy go, and a little bit stupid myself, that I didn't care! Let me tell you, I was obsessed with Sonic X growing up. I watched it every Saturday morning, I was on a mission to collect all the action figures, and here's a funny one, I even took my family's old Game Gear with me on trips so I could watch Sonic X in the car using an antenna attachment. Yes, really. You plugged a big box with an antenna into the game slot, and suddenly your Game Gear became a little black and white TV. And I used this feature exclusively to watch Sonic X when I wasn't home. It was, without a doubt, my number one favorite cartoon at the time. But even with all that, I never actually seen the entire series. I'm pretty sure I've mainly just seen the first season. Apparently they go into space by the end, which I definitely didn't see that one coming. But the reason I mainly just saw the first season was because I owned it on DVD. Kinda. Yeah, so one Christmas my dad gave me the Sonic X Complete Season 1 DVD set. But it didn't have the English dub. It was all in the original Japanese, which my dad didn't realize when he bought it. But it did have English subtitles, so little Baby Fofi could still follow along. But as I was watching the show and reading the subtitles, I started seeing new words. New four-letter words. New four-letter words that when I asked my dad what they meant, he was concerned. Turns out the original Japanese dub of Sonic X is littered with swear words! And when my dad found out, I was no longer allowed to watch that DVD with the subtitles on. And to me, that story is funnier than Sonic X itself could ever hope to be. So, that's the world of Sonic cartoons, according to me. It's kind of amazing how many vastly different shows we've gotten out of just Sonic Fights Eggman over the years. And I'm really interested to see how the heck this new Netflix cartoon puts its own spin on Sonic. Will it be funny? Will it be more serious? Will it be super faithful to the games? Will it kind of do its own thing? We don't know! But that's okay, because it's not the first Sonic cartoon, and it ain't gonna be the last. And if there's anything I want you to take away from this video, it's that Sonic taught me how to swear.